Hello everyone and welcome to this video. In this video, we'll see all the advanced features in Lightworks 14, such as effects and text. Leave suggestions in the video description to improve our next videos for the software. Let's assume you have the Lightworks project ready. You can add special visual and audio effects through the VFX and the audio workspaces that you can open through the tabs on top. The VFX workspace is used to apply video effects in order to adjust the appearance of videos and pictures or to add special visual effects, including text and transitions. To start off, select the clip where you would like to apply the effects by simply placing the red playhead on it. At this point, the effect panel opens on the left with a list of all the effects applied on each clip. By default, a single effect called color correction is present, which is used to adjust the colors inside the video or the picture clip. Under main, you can correct the color intensity through saturation and the contrast and the brightness with contrast and brightness. Under RGB, you can correct the color intensity, contrast, and brightness on each of the three main colors. Under HSV, you can use hue to change the overall colors inside the clip. You can add other visual effects by clicking on the plus button above and choosing the correct section on the right. The effects listed are divided between components, which are the main visual effects available, and the presets, which are ready-to-use effect templates where you can apply one or multiple effects. You can also enable the star icon on the left to include an effect or a template inside the favorites section. Double-click on an effect or a template to apply it on the clip. This will be added in the effect list under the Settings tab, complete with its name and settings at the bottom. Click on the name to rename the effect, and use the bars and the markers to edit the effect by checking the big preview on the right. You can also enable and disable each effect by clicking on the green light. Next to it, you can open the Settings menu to either reset the effect settings or remove the whole effect from the clip. All effects applied on clips are represented as small colored rectangles on the timeline. Besides visual effects, you can also apply text and titles. They are all listed inside the text section. There are three kinds of text: the crawl text, which goes from the left to the right, the roll, which creates a credit roll, and the titles, which are simple pieces of text. For all of these, the settings panel is the same. Type inside sample text to change the text content and regulate the font style below, such as the font family, the bold or italic effect, and the font size through size, and the font transparency through opacity. Additionally, under the Face tab, choose the right color for the text and apply either a solid color through flat color or a cool gradient with vertical gradient. Under Position, decide where to place the text in respect to the horizontal X or the vertical Y direction. You can also click and drag the text directly from the preview to move it. You can also apply shadow and outline glow by using shadow and outline. Enable the effect first, and then regulate them by checking the preview. Under the Effects tab, you can add fade transitions in order to make the text appear in and disappear out with a defined time length. If text is applied on a clip, the clip shows a green rectangle, and the text itself is dependent on it. This means that the text appears only through the entire clip duration. To create an independent piece of text, just place the red playhead on a vacant space and then add text. This is represented as a green clip on the timeline contained inside a new track called Effect or FX track. You can edit the text settings through the Effect panel inside the VFX workspace and regulate the clip in position and duration under the Edit workspace as a normal clip. You can also apply effect clips completely independent from clips in this way. Inside Lightworks, you can also apply effects with properties that change in time by using the keyframes. Keyframes are special markers that save, for a fixed instant of time, a defined set of properties for the specific effect. In this way, if you play back from the first keyframe to the following one, the effect changes in time from the properties of the first keyframe to the ones from the second keyframe. Several effect or text properties have a watch icon. If you turn it on, you will enable keyframes for the property. The keyframes bar at the bottom shows all the keyframes placed in time through the whole clip length. By default, two markers are placed at the beginning and at the end of the clip. You can use the left and the right arrow buttons to select the right keyframe in time. Hover over the first keyframe to fix the initial value for the property. Then, hover over the second one to set the final value. Check the preview to see the result. You can also add other keyframes by choosing another instant of time and changing the property on it. To remove a keyframe, just click on it to select it and use the minus button on the left. You can disable all the keyframes by turning off the watch icon. In case you have keyframes on multiple effects, you can manage them easier by using the Graphs tab. For each effect property that has keyframes, a graph is shown, representing each keyframe through circle points. The height of the circle represents the property value saved by the keyframe, and the horizontal position the instant of time from the beginning of the clip. You can edit each keyframe in time and properties by clicking and dragging it freely. You can also use the plus and the minus buttons to add or remove keyframes, and the green icon on top to enable or disable them. Keyframes are also used to apply visual fade-in and fade-out transitions to make clips appear and disappear. Inside the Mix section are all the visual effects which can be used to add transitions if you apply keyframes on them. A fade-in transition is added by passing from a 100% keyframe to a 0% one placed at the beginning of the clip. A fade-out transition is made by passing from 0% to 100% through the end of the clip. Remember that the transition duration is indicated by the time between the two keyframes. The last tab, called Routing, represents the order of all the effects applied on the clip, from top to bottom. By changing this order, you may change the final appearance of the clip. Take a look. All these settings, such as the keyframes and the routing, are completely independent between one clip and another. Now, let's take a look at the audio workspace. With respect to the VFX workspace, this is used to correct and adjust the audio files inside your timeline. On the audio clips, you can click and drag the dashed line to regulate the clip volume uniformly, or click and drag from the clip corners to apply volume fades. In the top right corner, you also have a master panel, used to control the way the audio tracks must interact. Each audio track is shown with its name at the bottom and its volume meter. The LR track on the right is the master track, which represents the sum of all the audio content of the project. To regulate the volume balance between the two stereo channels, use the panning knobs on top. To regulate the volume of each audio track, just click and drag from the blue markers you see. You can use these to reduce the volume, in case the volume meter falls inside the red color. Keep in mind that all these adjustments affect any audio clip inside the audio track. Additionally, you can use the effects panel in the top left corner to add audio effects and adjustments, such as the audio filters through the equalizer, EQ. The way to add, edit, and manage these audio effects is identical to the visual effects inside VFX, apart from the keyframes. Thanks for watching this video guide. Check out our channel for more amazing and free video guides.